Hello everyone. This tutorial I will show how to create drop-down menu, and I have built this using Java Swing, custom with animation and MIG layout library. And when we click on the menu item, we switch the panel form on the main form. Now let's start. Here I have create the project in NetBean, and I have some code in this project, the ripple effect class, used to make menu item effect. Windows 11 scroll bar custom. And the last is the shadow class to make menu item shadow. And for the library, I'm using timing framework for make animation, and MIG layout library for make the menu layout. For the Java version I'm using Java 8. Now we going to create the new package, and then create the menu class for menu custom. And for this class, we need extends from the J component. Create default constructor. Create the MIG layout object. And here create the menu item as the string array. We use two-dimensional because we have the submenu item. So we initialize the menu item here. For the first menu item we set as dashboard. And second menu item as email, and for the submenu item, we write with the email array. It mean the email menu have submenu as inbox, red, and compost, and for the dashboard it no have any submenu. Then we create the init method, then call it from the constructor. Initialize the MIG layout object here. For MIG layout, it have three arguments, layout, column, and row constraints. For the layout constraints, we use wrap1 for make the component have only one column, fillX to make horizontal fill, gapY 0, and inset2 for menu padding. And second arguments for the column constraints, so we use fill to make menu item fill to horizontal. Then set this layout to this current component. Next we going to set the string menu item array to the menu panel as menu item component. By create the new class as menu item and extends from the J button. In this menu item class, we create some object. Create index as integer to store menu index and submenu able to note this menu item have any submenu. And here we have submenu index and length as the submenu array size. For the constructor, we have three arguments, name of the menu, index, and submenuable. Call super constructor and pass variable name for set text to J button, it the same with method set text. And create one method for initialize submenu, we call this method when this item as the submenu, so here we need initialize the submenu index and length. Now encapsulation these fields, for get method setter and getter. So we have the menu item class as the J button custom. So now we can use it in menu class to create the menu item component. Create method add menu, have two arguments, menu name and index. Create variable length to store the length of the array by index, so the first length of the menu item array, it should be 1, and the second it should be 4. Now create menu item object and pass the menu name, index, and for submenuable we set as length greater than 1, so when the length of array greater than 1 it mean the menu have submenu. Then add this menu item to this component, and don't forget to call method revalidate for update the layout, and method repaint to update the graphics. So here we create the for loop from menu item array. And call method add menu, so this loop we get only the first element, not for the submenu item element. Here we get I index and 0 index. So when this loop run, we will get the dashboard and email. Now for see the result of this menu that we have custom, so we going to create new JFRAM. Right-click on the JFRAM and select Property, then select on Tab Code, and check Generate Center for make the JFRAM show center of the screen. Now we create new panel for JFRAM background. Here create the scroll pane window 11 class that I have in this project, I move it to the FRAM. And we set width of the scroll menu as 250 pixel. And here check this vertical resize button to make this scroll menu auto resize when FRAM size change. Next move the menu class and drop into the scroll pane. Now we have two main menu, so we can add more menu here. Next we going to create the submenu when we click on the which menu have submenu able. So here we add menu item action listener, this event run when user click on the menu. We show the menu when length of array greater than 1. So now we can output text for test here. Next we create the method add submenu. Create new J panel, then we will add all the submenu item into this J panel. And this J panel we also use MIG layout the same as the menu panel. Set opaque false to remove background color. Now loop all the submenu item array and add it to the panel. We use submenu able false because we not have any submenu. Then call method in its submenu in menu item object. Pass submenu index and length of the submenu. Next add it into panel. So after for loop, we need to call method revalidate for update layout and repaint for update graphics. And then add submenu panel to main menu panel. So we call method add submenu here. But the submenu is show at the bottom of menu, we need show at bottom of the menu item we have clicked. Here we use method getComponentZOrder to get index of the menu item. And when we add submenu panel, we add to index ZOrder plus 1. But we see the duplicate email item, so now we need skip the first index of the submenu array. Set for loop to start with 1. For easy view, we set content area filled to false for the submenu item. And thank you everyone for watching. See you next video.